Sir, I am taking full responsibility for being late with the application. I'm simply asking for a deadline extension. Well, I'm asking that you not punish Adam O'Brien, who's already had a tough enough life for my mistake. Sir, all I'm saying is, these words will travel through the minds of stubborn parties and unbind. Thoughts too rigid to be kind. A compromise they'll disentwine.
How does 6 o'clock on Friday sound?
6 o'clock Friday is perfect. Thank you so much. Victory!
You got the extension.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. You're in all that witchy stuff, right?
Excuse me?
Well, I'm just thinking that there must be something in the stars today. I mean, Billy's face, my car, now this. Is there a full moon or something?
I don't know, but whatever it is, I'm gonna call my student loan sharks and take full advantage of it.
You good, me too.
You know, Paige, as a lawyer, I could get those nasty creditors off your back so easily. And if you can't afford to pay me, we could always just take it out and trade.
Or I could just sue your ass for sexual harassment and pay you with my big fat punitive settlement.
The way you dress, a judge would admire my restraint.
That's it. Perfect. I'll just change Demon to Dirtbag.
I don't understand how someone can be that stupid.
I don't understand why you haven't stopped ranting since we left the house.
You're right. You're right. I'm sorry.
Yes, Paige made a mistake.
A mistake? She stole from us.
She borrowed. Borrowed.
She threw our family heritage out of the window.
Well, that's because we never took the time to explain its significance. It was just a book to her.
Okay, Phoebe, it is not just a book. It's like, it is like part of our family.
Paige is not a killer. She didn't kill anyone, and she's not a demon that we're on our way to vanquish.
I get that, Phoebe.
Do you? Because I don't think that you do.
All right.
Hey, get him quick from me! What
the hell is going on?
It's not funny! Oh,
got it. You mama some sugar.
Wait.
Woo! Who's the man? Who's the man?
You are. Of course, my man.
Yes, you are so.
Busted? Hello. You stole our sacred book so you could perform magical plastic surgery on yourself?
You think I did this on purpose? My body was perfectly fine just as it was, thank you.
I made it! Get away from me!
Piper, you could have just blown up a dozen innocent people.
I took a chance.
See, are you listening to yourself?
What happened?
I don't know. They just grew.
Oh, right. And you had nothing to do with that.
Did you cast any spells?
One. Five.
Five? Okay, what did you do just before you turned into Betty Boop?
Well, I cast a spell on the slime ball I work with so I could give him a taste of his own medicine.
Uh-huh. That the slime ball?
And that's the backfire.
Backfire?
Misused magic to make him the object of ogling. And the spell backfired and did the same thing to you.
Which you would have learned if you had bothered to ask, but now, instead of vanquishing demons, we're gonna have to spend the afternoon fixing your mess.
Okay, Piper, call Leo and get him to orb this slime ball back home. I mean, we have to protect him until we can figure out a way to reverse the spell. Paige and I will grab the book and meet you there.
Stay this way forever.
Not if I can ever find the spell.
What about Piper? Is she gonna stay mad at me forever?
No. It's just, she hasn't really been herself lately. You know, a lot of ups and downs since Prue, you know, like us all.
The last thing I wanted to do was to add to her dry stress. I just wanted to get back at Donnie.
Yeah, and I understand the temptation, Paige. I really do, but I told you the book does not leave the house.
Right. Sorry.